five albums that if you were stranded on an island, you could, that those were the only songs that you could listen to. All 20 of those songs on, so you could only listen to what was on those albums. Number five for me, Love Is Rage 2, Lil Uzi. This is an album that came out 2017, sort of at the peak, kind of at the peak of the SoundCloud mumble rap era, whatever you want to call that. This album is, I mean, this had EXO Tour Life on the album. This is where Uzi really started to get commercial success. We all knew Uzi from, you know, Money Longer. We knew him from Lil Uzi Versus the World. Like, that was his first breakthrough, but this was his first, like, oh, he's up here performing with Ed Sheeran at the VMAs or whatever award show that was. EXO Tour Life is a generational classic song. Why I love this album so much is because there's so many songs on here, like early 20 Rager, where it doesn't make sense. It shouldn't make sense, but it does, because it sounds incredible. This is like a creative masterpiece of sounds. Some stuff that has never been made before and has honestly never been created since or recreated. 20 songs, I mean, speaking of 20 Minutes is one of my favorite songs of all time. It came on the deluxe version of the album. Under Pressure by Logic. And I know a lot of people are probably going to call me corny for this. A lot of people are going to call me corny, and I don't really give a fuck, honestly. This album holds like a special place in my heart. Logic is my favorite rapper. I found him when I was a junior in high school. I was 16 years old, something 17. And he was just doing like his Young Sinatra mixtapes, and I just loved him. I loved his charisma. I loved his vibe. I loved how positive he was, and he was good. He still is, but like, that's what really drew me to him, and I could relate to him in a sense. I could see myself in him in a sense, and honestly, we don't really realize it, but that's why we like the artists that we do. I'll let you think about that. But anyway, I'm going to talk about Under Pressure a little bit. In the truest sense, this is just a hip-hop album. And honestly, I love hip-hop. It's rap, like real rap, lyrical rap, honestly, is great. But honestly, this album has that. It's a hip-hop album, but it has songs like that kind of bend it. It kind of blends R&B a little bit to this. But Under Pressure just has like a really, it's just a complete project. It's a complete cohesive work of art. And these next three are probably really obvious if you know me. But number three for me is My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy by Kanye. I don't really feel like I have to say too much on this, but like, when this came out, what is this, 2011 or something like that? So I was like a freshman in high school. It was one of those albums that I didn't listen to when it came out, like 2011, like when it came out. But like we all heard Power, we all knew the big songs on Dark Fantasy. This is one of arguably the greatest albums of all time. This is Kanye's magnum opus, honestly. This is his, if you know what I mean by that, this is Kanye's iPhone. If you get the reference, like, yeah, Steve Jobs, you know, made the iMac look cool, all that stuff, you know, the fat iMac with the color back. But when he came out with that iPhone, that changed the game. And he came out with some cool stuff after, you know, Apple TV, MacBook, that iPhone, though. Everyone on the planet Earth knows a song from this album. This is a masterpiece, and I know every word to every song. Number two, Take Care, Drake. Come on. Now, I can say this album, 2012, I believe, me and my homies, we were bumping this when this came out. So this is what shaped my high school age. Like, me and my friends, this is what shaped us in high school. Like, I will always remember those times, you know, being freshly 16, listening to Take Care top to bottom. This is a perfect masterpiece. It has, I mean, again, sort of like what I was saying with Under Pressure. Under Pressure is maybe 85% hip-hop, 15% other stuff. I feel like Take Care is a perfect blend of hip-hop, in R&B. And I don't know if anyone's ever been able to recreate something like just like this. Like, yeah, you got people like Tory Lanez now who sing and rap, but he's mostly singing. But Drake found a way, and in the time period that Drake did this into is just, I mean, it's crazy. This is what propelled him. This is Drake's magnum opus. And I don't know if he's ever been able to get back to there. Maybe that's controversial, but that's not what this conversation is about. My number one album, favorite album of all time, 808 and Heartbreak by Kanye West. Album that I can revisit and know every single word to every single song, and I feel amazing every time I listen to it. As the music nerd in me really appreciates this and puts this at number one because of the time period, 2008. And I actually, not even trying to be pretentious, I keep using that word, but for real, but I got this was the first CD that I ever got in my entire life in 2008. I got it for Christmas. I listened to it and it was all like slow music and like sort of sad, and like, you know, you hear the term alternative R&B so much now. This is like invented in alternative R&B, because back then you had 2008 Neo and Jeremiah and Lloyd, and that type of stuff was R&B, but it was like poppy R&B, or you had like a little bit, you kind of blended to something like, you know, the Fugees, that was like funkish a little bit. But this is like, people were using auto-tune, but Kanye and T-Pain were like the first two artists to really perfect the use of auto-tune. This album is incredible. So there's my list, my top five favorite albums of all time. Please tag me in yours. I would love for, you know, to get this conversation going, to get other people's list. What do you guys rate mine? Yeah.